in the last 2 years back called IBC. IBC in short is called Insolvency Banking Code. You will say, no, don't talk to me of a law. It's a non. I'm not going to talk to you about law. Insolvency Banking Code has nothing to do with law, but it has something to do with a good business principle. Previously, when a businesses used to borrow and borrow money heavily, 30,000 crore, 40,000 crore, they used to think that if I cannot pay back the money, the government and RBI and the bankers will figure out a way how I will get the old money to get back, pay back the, how I will get the new money to pay back the old money. But Insolvency Banking Code, what it has done, that if you have a due to the banking system, by the way, when a bank gives money to the industrialists or to the entrepreneurs, bank gives your and my money. It is our money. You, every one of us put money in the bank. That money goes for lending. And if that money does not come back, your and my money becomes unsafe. And that is what was happening to the country. For all those who are finance people are understanding a little bit of business, perhaps you will know that the NPA, the non-performing asset of this country, was already 12%. That means for every 100 rupees we used to put into the banking system, 12 rupees would never come back, because 12 rupees the entrepreneurs were not giving back. And there was no way by the bankers were able to tell the industrialists, Baba, kuch karo, return my money, because they knew they had their birthright with their businesses. IBC has said, Insolvency Banking Code has said, that if you don't return the money within 330 days, I'll give you 90 days first time, and then I will give you another 330 days. If you don't do that, I am going to auction your company out. You will lose control of your company. Out you go. That's why Bhushan Steel has become Tata Steel. Do you think Bhushan Steel would have ever thought they will become Tata Steel? SR Steel, can you believe SR Steel, such a huge conglomerate, has now become ArcelorMittal Steel? Why? One law, IBC. Why? Because these entrepreneurs borrowed your and my money, but did not return the money in spite of repeated cajoling that please return our money. Ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to say you that the ecosystem of this country has significantly has got improved in terms of, it has got strengthened. This, if we would have done, let's say 30, 40, 50 years before, things may have been different, but we did not do, no point in talking of the past. You will say, now you prove me this is good for the country. I will prove you now. When did the COVID hit us? The COVID hit India on March 2020. Am I right? 20th of 21st of March, I think Prime Minister shut everything down and the curfew started. That was the trigger point. And it started about 10, 15 days before that. In the month of January, okay, before that, again, I understand that all of you may not be financially savvy. If I ask you a question, how do you make out that a country is doing well? How do you make out? India is doing well, US is doing well, Japan is doing well, South Korea is doing, how do you make out? The single most popular metrics is GDP growth. People say GDP growing, gross domestic product. GDP is growing, gross domestic product. Country's wealth is growing, so country must be doing well. This is one way of figuring it out. The second way of figuring it out is the per capita income growing? If the per capita income grows, again, the country must be doing well. Chalo, ye bhi theek hai. GDP growing, which did not grow. Of course, it grew only at 4%. It used to grow at 7-8% earlier. It did not grow. Per capita income, grow, not grow. It is not growing. The population is very high. Chalo, theek hai. Can you name a third factor? The third factor which determines the country is doing well or not. Let me tell you the third factor. And all of you should keep a track of it. It's called the PMI index. PMI index means Purchase Managers Index. The world across, every month, the purchase managers are asked, are you optimistic or are you pessimistic? They ask this question, simple question they ask. If there is optimism, the marking is more than 50%. If there is pessimism, the marking is less than 50%. In the last seven years in India, the second highest PMI index was in January 2020, ladies and gentlemen. It was 55.3 was a PMI index 2 months before COVID hit us. The India, which means, was actually taking off. You will say, no, but that must be flash in the can. The second was in February 2020. The February 2020, the number was 54.5, third highest in the last 7 years. Ladies and gentlemen, India was just taking off, only to be badgered. And I don't know whether there is any other worse word than that, that India has gone towards sixer because of sudden attack of COVID in March 2020, and the rest is history as of now. I wanted to only communicate to you that COVID is going to go. It will go in 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, whenever it will go. But the Indian ecosystem has become much more internationally competitive. You will say, well, is that true? You see, in order to do business, you need four things. You need land, you need labor, you need capital, and you need organization. This is Lord Keynes' theory, and this is theory for last 100 years, and it will last for the next maybe 1,000 years. Land, labor, capital, organization. These are the four inputs which you give to a business, to any economy. Land, already the government has kept aside land, as you know, hundreds and thousands of hectares already kept aside for new businesses to start and come in. Labor, may have heard that the country's labor is a state law. It cannot be done by central government. Then state government protected the labor like anything. The labor in Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh, these are the two largest states in the country, has been completely liberalized. And if you have understanding law, then I'll tell you, in these two countries, in these two states, the Factories Act and the Industrial Disputes Act have been kept in abeyance for next 3 years. What does it mean? Have been kept in abeyance, which means that you can hire and fire anybody in Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. There is no Industrial Disputes Act, so nobody can complain. You cannot even go to the court and say, see, I have lost my job. It's gone, finished, over. The law has changed forever. Now, if Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh has started, and it's a state law, as I'm saying, West Bengal will start, Kerala will start, Maharashtra has already started giving 12 hours work being allowed. It was unheard of that you employ people in Maharashtra more than 8 hours. Now 12 hours is no problem at all, no problem. So Gujarat has also done the same thing. So what's happening? Land already has been identified and kept aside. Labor laws are now getting singularly liberalized, hire and fire, and that will enhance employment. Capital. You just heard 1 month back, 2 weeks back, the government has announced a 20 lakh crore package. Many of you said 20 lakh crore, but I've heard in television, they're saying it's all useless. 20 lakh crore package, which was 10% of GDP, and all those who can understand English economics, our GDP is about 290 lakh crore, about 300 lakh crore. So they were saying out of 20 lakh crore, only 3 lakh crore will be given away, 17 lakh crore will never be given away. It's all nonsense. The government, first of all, if you have a business, and if you have a business which is worth it, there's no dirt of money. The last week, the chairman of SBI has publicly gone and said, he's saying, I have 1 lakh crore money, but I don't know whom to give. He doesn't know whom to give. Believe me, that's the situation. If you have a good project, if yet the project is worthwhile for the future and the cash flows are correct, there is no dirt of money. While I would have touched this subject a little later, but let me tell you one little thing, what's happening to this country. And this is a new business opportunity. This 20 lakh crore, such, you know, it's a gem. My humble submission to all of you who are in the business, please go and see what is this 20 lakh crore, which are the projects and which are the sectors they are looking at. Out of this 20 lakh crore, my dear friends, and many of you must be actually struggling, thinking, what should I do next? And what should I do? Tell my children? What should I tell my brothers, my cousins to do? They're all under depression. 1 lakh crore out of this 20 lakh crore, ladies and gentlemen, has been kept aside for agriculture infrastructure. They have identified every item of agriculture where there is a scope to enhance India's productivity, India's export, India's self-sufficiency. They have gone into such depth, they've identified something called a bee cultivation for honey, bee cultivation for honey. And they have allocated 500 crores, yes, 500 crores for bee cultivation. They have identified animal husbandry. Maybe there's a huge opportunity. India can actually export a lot of meat. They have kept for pisciculture. They have kept some for 1,500 crores for fish and pisciculture. Now, please let us look at wherever there is this infrastructure, agricultural infrastructure, 1 lakh crore. You will say, no, but 1 lakh crore will never be spent. Chalo, 1 lakh crore will never be spent. Adha to hoga, 50,000 crore. If that 50,000 crore, I mean, we can get 1/100th of that. Just imagine the amount of money and the business opportunities we are talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, India has just opened up. As the COVID was hitting us, India was in a takeoff state. It's a fact. Please, after this call, look into the Google auntie and see what was the PMI index of January and what was the PMI index of February. And you will just see this was the highest in last 7 or 8 years, one of the highest. You also know that IBC has come in. And therefore, these entrepreneurs who used to loot the country and not give the money back, it's all now settled. Therefore, what's happening, whoever is taking loan, they are thinking 100 times whether I should take the loan again or not, because I have to return. If I do not return, my company will be taken away, rightly so. You have taken a loan and you have taken my money, your money, and therefore you have to give it back. That's how it works all over the world. Why should India be indifferent? And because this discipline was not there, many of these companies were sucking out countries' economy and not giving back. This is economics. This is nothing to do with politics. This is complete economics. And I'm not a political person. I'm a businessman like you and most of us. The GST and demonetization has brought sanity into the market in some form. Of course, some of it may have affected because people who were doing cash business may have got affected. By the way, you will say, but cash business has got affected. When the demonetization took place, the quantum of cash in the country was 18 lakh crore. Today, it is 21 lakh crore. And the quantum of cash has actually gone up. If you still want to do business on cash, there is no problem. But yes, please pay the taxes. Otherwise, perhaps there could be a problem. Having said that, the country's fourth thing, land, labor, capital, organization. Organization is you and me. That is management. That government doesn't give. Has again changed the ecosystem. Having said that, this particular economic package, which has just got announced, has given to my mind areas of huge opportunities. I did talk about agricultural infrastructure. Let me give you one more example, and I would hasten to request all of you who are in the business, who are looking for opportunities, to look at this economic structure, this economic package. I'm of course available all the time, and if you feel no, this I'm not able to understand, explain to me, happy to explain. They have kept aside money for atomic energy. Research on atomic energy. You will say, oh, acha, they are now talking about sending rockets to the moon. No, ladies and gentlemen, you know what they're trying to say? This atomic energy research, which the company, I think the country has kept us at 1,500 crores or 2,000 crores, whatever, some obscene sum of large money. They have kept aside this money, atomic energy, to enhance the life of food on the shop shelves. Just imagine. Do you know the milk? When we used to have milk in the earlier days, we milk had to be consumed in one day, otherwise kharab ho jate the. Aaj milk, you can homogenize milk, you can keep the homogenized milk for a month or two, no problem. Just imagine, can I buy apple and keep it for 1 year? Can I keep banana for next 6 months? Can I keep my sabji for next 6 months? Just imagine, you will solve the food problem of the world almost immediately. And that's what the government is focusing on. This economic package is truly a visionary. And where each one of us, and based on what we believe our core competencies are, if you are an atomic energy guy, if you are, let's say, an animal husbandry guy, or you are somebody who wants to do something agriculture, go to the bee cultivation. This is honey. Honey is the biggest immunity builder in the world. And India has honey. India has another opportunity. The best immunity developer is Ayurveda. And in Ayurveda, the single most important item is turmeric powder, turmeric. India grows turmeric. Can we make this turmeric a global game plan? We can do that but now is the time when people are looking at immunity building, because this is the time for immunization. Tulsi is the first one. Galam couscous, because that's how this whole COVID starts. Have Tulsi, warm water Tulsi is gone. Can we make Tulsi a global player? So there are opportunities which has just cropped up, which was not available there. You must be all aware that India, just give an example, a success story. What has happened, two success stories which has happened, how people have taken advantage, and many of you perhaps have already done it. The sugar factories in India, were all making losses. They produce ethanol. Sugar factories have now started making sanitizers, hand sanitizers. Each loss-making company is now printing money. They are printing money. India never had the hazmat suits or the PPE suit, personal protective equipment suits, the COVID suits, never had. We always imported. Today, India makes 4 lakh COVID suits every day, every day. So something which was zero had suddenly boomed. Of course, something which was booming has become zero. For instance, you had a booming restaurant business, doesn't exist anymore. There was an airlines business, doesn't exist anymore. You had a hotel, I exist. Hotel, to my mind, is not going to go. Hotel, again, I think it's a time when you have to reinvent yourself and do it COVID-proof, and then hotels will work for sure, because many hotels have just made it for COVID people. They have converted that and they are minting money. Just go to the Orchid Hotel near the Bombay airport. They are minting money, but they just converted that hotel into a COVID hotel and they are minting money. They have just made it in that way. So there are sectors which are suddenly growing. And I would like to name 3 sectors in my view, it's 12:40. I'll take 2-3 minutes more to give you name to 3 or 4 sectors where I believe there's a lot of opportunities. One sector is health, goes without saying. Anything to do with health. Health, let me give you an example. In India, you have hospitals at the upper level, you are called sick, you need an operation, you go to hospital. And the lowest level is dispensaries, it's pharmacy shops. In the middle, is there anything? Nothing. But there in the world, all over, and many of you have traveled and do keep traveling, there is something called a recuperating center, which is called primary health center. There is the whole middle level is completely empty. There is either hospital or there are dispensaries. What about middle? Like say a lady has just given birth to a child and needs a recuperating center for 15 days. What happens? You had an operation and you're going to recuperate for next 15 days, 1 month. What happens? You have small little sickness. You can't stay at home. You need primary health care, health intervention. What happens? There isn't anything. The whole middle portion is empty. And that's where America and Germany and Europe is very, very strong. Another opportunity, immunity building system. I gave you turmeric. I gave you examples of Tulsi. It's a huge opportunity. Of course, Ramdev Baba said that he has already invented COVID medicine, which I don't think is true. By the way, that's another matter altogether. Please take it with a pinch of salt. Whatever I was reading about it, that the testing which he has done has not been tested on people who are 60 years and above, and people who are having oxygen dilation less than 90. So that he has not tested. So I think it is a little bit of question mark which one that one is, but that's another matter altogether. So again, yes, there's a hope, at least the hope is coming up. So health is one sector which will do anything. The second sector which will do extremely well is education. You will say, education, how can education be a health sector? You know, if you wanted to do a good degree, you had to travel to US, Harvard. You go to US, Chicago School. You go to US, UK, London Business School. But today, all these qualifications will be sitting at home. It's not going to happen next 2-4 years, maybe. India will be the hub because we know English. We speak English. We English is the medium of a language. Many, many courses are there in the world, which only opportunities going to Harvard or to business schools. Can we do something from India? And it's a great opportunity. The third one is food. Actually, the food should be the second, and third should be education. I give you some examples. Apple juice. Do you know in tomato, India imports tomato ketchup? Sorry, tomato purees. India, 50% of tomato gets wasted. We don't even collect. So this whole agricultural infrastructure building, perhaps this 1 lakh crore, might solve this problem hugely. Please look at these opportunities. So health, food, education are the next vistas of opportunities are going to open. Another area of opportunity for all those who are consultants is consultancy for giving turning around businesses. Lots of businesses are going to go sick. Many will become bankrupt. So you need to turn them around. So if you have a 360 degrees of view, either you have been in business for all this time or you're business management educated, you have a 360 degrees of view of a business, 360 degrees views of business, I mean, you know how to purchase, how to sell, how to produce, how to do IT, little, you don't have to be expert in anything, little, you know everything, and therefore you are able to see what the business strategy should be. And very important, business is operations. You must not think, but also deliver. It's not enough to have a fantastic restaurant, but you cannot serve good food within 10 minutes of time of an arrival of a guest. So to cut the long story short, yes, things look difficult. But before the COVID came, India was in a takeoff stage. COVID is going to go. Today, tomorrow, day after, it is going to go. It is going away in many countries already. What we are going to get back is the old ecosystem. Already things were looking good. Now with this new economic package, India is focusing on core competency areas. This Atmanirbhar is a good idea that we have to produce ourselves. We need to produce ourselves for sure, but the trade between the countries must continue, because unless it is a free flow of trade, the country cannot do well. So there are lots of opportunities. Look at this economic package. If you are looking for businesses, I have just named a few. I'm happy to answer, of course, areas of trouble which you have. But please, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, there is still 7.5 billion people in the world. There's still 1.5 billion people in India. They will still need food and clothing and shelter. And therefore, for every one of us, there's enough business. It's only what has happened. It has changed. The habits and demand and requirements have changed. Let us supply those demand. Let us reskill ourselves. And each one of us will have to reinvent ourselves. This is the key word. Moment to reinvent, you'll be much better off. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It is 1:45.
Wow, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Robin. I mean, your talk is so encouraging and totally positive. So, members, the business opportunities are unlimited for India as per what we just heard. I'm sure that the floor is open for questions. Robin, I also have a question, but I leave it open for the members now. Manoj?
Yeah, people can talk, yes. Yeah, Abu sir, you can go ahead with yours.
Yeah, Robin, so as you said that about the industries which you said, so all the industries related to what... as you said, the factories there in China, there are chances that they may come to India. Do you think that labor would also play a very important part in this? That labor provided, because in the Chinese labor is very cheap compared to India.
Chinese labor is 25% more expensive than India. As of today, 23rd of June 2020. It was cheap 5 years back, 4 years back. Last 3 years, China has made a law for minimum wages, and the average wage of a Chinese is 25% more on a like-to-like proficiency and experience level. China is no longer labor cost effective anymore. It used to be, that is how it started. The Foxconn, the largest factory in the world, which produces Apple and all the computers, it started because the labor was cheap. It is no longer true. But there are two advantages in China. China has cheap interest cost of capital is low. China is still cheap power cost. Power cost and capital cost is lower. But if you look at the costing of a manufactured product, let me tell you now, let me wear my hat of my finance guy. The cost of raw material will be 60 to 65%. And therefore the 30-35% is the value addition. The value addition will be around typically 10% labor and about 2-3% cost of capital. And about 3-4% will be power, energy, barring, of course, let's say aluminum, with energy only. Most of it is therefore 3-5% is the cost disadvantage India has. But that cost disadvantage, India's labor is cheaper. To my mind, it makes over the cost disadvantage. And what more we have to do, we have to enhance our productivity. That means same labor should produce double. And the cost of labor comes down. So we have to now restructure. See, thinking China mein labor sasta, wo to hai nahi. Thinking China mein scale hai, hai to abhi kya karega? Scale hai uska. उसका फॉक्सकॉन फैक्ट्री इतना बड़ा है, लेट मी टेल यू, आई वाज पासिंग अ फॉक्सकॉन फैक्ट्री इन अ ट्रेन एंड आई कुड नॉट सी द एंड ऑफ द फॉक्सकॉन फैक्ट्री. इट वाज ओवर मोर देन 15 हेक्टर्स ऑफ लैंड. इट वाज वन फैक्ट्री एम्प्लॉइंग अपेरेंटली 150,000 पीपल अंडर वन रूफ. बट दैट्स द स्केल, वी कांट डू दैट. बट व्हाट वी कैन डू, लेट अस डू. कैन वी बी बेटर देन ऑस्ट्रेलिया, न्यूजीलैंड, Ghana, Nigeria, Kenya, there are 200 other countries in the world where we can base, better be. Why think of China and हम लोग मरते रहते हैं चाइना को बात करते करते. China has an advantage, Your advantage is gone, Abu Zar sir.
That is. Yeah, in morning actually our midterm chat group we had got a video of Australia and some minister lady, she was talking that it's time that now Australia starts manufacturing a lot of item on its own. So I think all countries all over the world are perhaps looking at it of not importing from China.
Absolutely right.
Uttara, your hand is up. You can ask a question.
Yeah, I just wanted to know what is your view of the retail sector?
Tectonic change. You will keep buying your shampoos and soaps. You will keep buying, but you will buy sitting at home. That's the change. So you will not go to a shop, but you will see on Amazon of the world and buy at home. So what will happen? The logistics sector will improve for deliveries at home. You don't have to take your car to get it delivered. Get it. So tectonic change.
Abu Zar,
so sector, the FMCG companies, industrial,
yes, Anil,
is doing much better. The share price is going up because his demand has gone up. Whereas the method of purchasing has shifted. So if you are owning a high street shop, I would think you must juggle your business and make it on delivery mode rather than asking people to come to your place and buy it.
Anil Ambo?
Robin?
Yes, sir.
Anil Ambo here. I totally agree with your thinking, your positivity and the changes that you're talking about, 100%. Where I want your input, the challenge in concept, all this is very good. But in implementation, the years of corruption in India, the years of inefficiency, what are your views? What do we need to do in that area so that the country goes through a faster change than just being on paper?
You have asked corruption and implementation. Let me handle corruption first.
And inefficiency.
Inefficiency. Yes, labor productivity perhaps.
Yeah, productivity, correct.
Corruption. The good news, Anil Bhai, is that most of the sectors now are out of licensing. So you don't need to go to government for getting any license or permission. Most of the permissions willy-nilly has come under ease of doing business concept. Most of it. Well, we used to spend, let's say, 20-30% of time to interact with the state officials, government officials, municipal officials. That 20-30% may have come down to 1-2% because I also run a company. So fortunately, we have got freed of that time. That 1-2% is still corruption. There is fact. There is now no beating around the bush. India is what India is. To get rid of corruption, historical evidence shows it takes two generations. And do you know what is a generation? Generation is defined as 20 years. So it will take 40 years for us to get rid of corruption, which has already started. But therefore, our children also may not get the benefit. Our grandchildren perhaps will be getting the benefit of New India. We have to live with it. But percentage of corruption time spent is going to go down. That's going to happen. More and more UODB will come. What is UODB? Use of Doing Business will come. More and more transparency in application on computer will come. Automatic permissions will happen. Yeah, hone wala hi hai. Hone wala hi hai because India has to attract business. Our India does not attract business, the government will not be voted, they will go away. So in their own interest, they will have to make ease of doing business. Because unless industries start, factories are starting, isko vote nahi dega. Koi government ko vote nahi dega. That's the power of democracy we have. As regards inefficiency is concerned, I agree. What has happened, sir, is Anil Bhai, there are pockets of states where the people are very efficient. Like if you set up a factory, I'm just giving a live example. If you have set up a factory in Thane, as opposed to Nasik, Nasik employees are more concerned to save the jobs because they know, but if I lose the job, I don't have another job. Therefore, they are very efficient. in Thane, they know I'm very close to Bombay. If I lose the job, I'll get a job in Bombay. So they are inefficient. Gujarat is efficient, very efficient. Go to Uttar Pradesh, the factories are not. But what has Uttar Pradesh government done? They bola, theek hai, chalo, factories act hi bana kar dete. Chalo, factories act hai. Abhi kya karega? If you are not efficient, you'll be sacked. And there's no industrial disputes act. You can't go and complain. So willy-nilly, these people have to become efficient. All this migrant labor which has gone back to Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, sir, they will be very efficient because they think that they can go under Manrega program, as you know. Manrega means if you dig a hole, you get some money. But theek hai, you dig a hole, you get 2,000 rupees. Then what? They are already used to the lifestyle of the cities. So to my mind, this migrating labor will bring efficiency to those people because they have a value system of cities. So believe me, in the next 1 year, you will see a new India, Anil Bhai. You will see, I'm saying 1 year. I'm not saying 10 years, 30 years. 10 years, 30 years, main nahi dikhunga. I'm not even concerned about that. I'm concerned about next year. Kya hona wala hai bata.
If it is 1 year, we are most happy.
Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, who's this?
Vicky Punjabi.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Robin Saab, good afternoon. Vicky Punjabi here.
Hello, Vicky.
Can you add something on the bureaucracy and corruption and inefficiencies? I mean, this is also going to be a part of New India. So, to be in tandem to make India grow, no?
Yeah, just to give you a little heads up on this, I am the chairman of CII, Ace of Doing Business, East Western India. So we are working with the government to see that an industrialist does not need to go to a bureaucrat's office. That's the way corruption starts. If I have to go to his or her office, that's where this starts. Already things have started. If you file a GST return, it is automatically approved. If you file an income tax return, it's automatically approved. Things are moving, but these bureaucrats don't want to make changes. So, hum log koshish kar rahe hain. Things are improving, sir. What it was 5 years back, things are better today. Hopefully, it will be better after 3 years. But do you think that will it be better in 2021? I don't think so. But the ecosystem is going to be better. You will have better land to be available. You will have labor to be working. You will have capital available. You will have risk taking abilities. All this will improve. Try to do in a business where bureaucrats are not involved. Chances are that there are most of the businesses, bureaucrats are not involved anymore, unless yes. You are in defense sector. In the defense sector also, in the new economic package, defense sector has also said that you can get into defense, 72% you can have foreign investment and start a business, automatic license. Even that has started. To be very honest, I'm optimistic on this. I think we can still do good business without bureaucrats.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, Sucharita.
Yeah. What do you have to say about the labor laws where most of our companies have been started about 50 years ago? So we are bound by the older labor laws and the unions. How do you see the future of unions and the relations that we're going to have with the existing unions and the existing workers who are today over 55 years old or 50 years old and are still commanding very high wages, but productivity is down and there's very little one can do with such people. You just have to keep them on.
So, Charita, which state is are your factories?
Maharashtra, Karnataka.
Karnataka hasn't started, first of all, as I said, the state governments have started making labor laws not only simple, they are saying, yeah, hai nahi, labor law hi nahi hai. They have kept Factories Act in abeyance. In abeyance, kya malum hai? Factories Act hai nahi. They have said Industrial Disputes Act is in abeyance. Means, wo kanuni nahi hai. Now, if Karnataka has to attract, tomorrow he has to also do what Mr. Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh is doing. Mm-hmm. Already Uddhav Thackeray's government have given in Maharashtra 12 hours work permit instead of 18. You can now employ 12 hours, no question asked. Mm-hmm. In fact, well, in our own interest, we must adjust for salary from 8 to 12 hours. But if you pay 8 hours salary and make them work 12 hours, allowed in Maharashtra. Mm-hmm. So labor laws have started changing when COVID had to come and start change. Why it didn't happen for the last 73 years? Now, don't ask me the question. I don't have the answer because I'm not a politician. Therefore, yeah. I think, Sucharita, in the next 1 year, you will see significant changes in labor laws because labor is a state subject. The state governments to attract industry, they will have to match Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Now, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh doesn't have a port. So, therefore, businesses are not going to go there. it is Maharashtras of the world and Karnatakas of the world where business is going to come. And therefore, the industry is going to say, aap Madhya Pradesh ka law banao, to main aata hun. Wo karna hai padega.
Hope so.
If they don't, then Karnataka will remain behind and some other states will go and use, like you are an industrialist, you will move to Madhya Pradesh where there is no labor law. Kabhi bhi hire karo, kabhi bhi fire karo. Of course, there are other considerations.
Labor
is not the only thing.
Thank you, Robin.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Okay.
Can I ask one more question if I have time permitting?
Okay, so Anil Ambo, so this is, okay. Go on, Anil.
You talked about industrial, agricultural infrastructure improvement, but there is no income tax and that's an area in agriculture which is used as siphoning out all the money from everywhere else. So what about the reforms in that sector? How will they happen?
It's not going to happen. Agricultural income tax is a state subject. It is not a central subject as per constitution. Ye constitution, humara India ka constitution sahi nahi hai, which I shouldn't say. But actually, it is a fact. Income tax, whether it is agriculture or pisciculture or steel or iron, if you have income, you pay income tax. But that is not so. Yeah. And it's not going to happen because the local state politicians who couch their income under agriculture income is not going to bring agriculture income tax in a hurry. So I think next 10 years, unless there is a significant set of politicians who are future minded comes up, and changes the ecosystem, it's not going to happen. Because they have to always go back to the democracy and seek votes. And the moment they bring in agriculture income tax, whoever brings it, they will lose election. That's what their research reports are always saying. There are good governments. There are governments which really thinks ahead of time, but they are not able to serve because they are doing market research. They are finding that moment they bring it, they will lose election. And that's another opportunity for the opposition to say, "Dekho, this anti-poverty hai, anti-agriculturist hai, anti-aam aadmi hai. Therefore, yeh sarkar ko ula do." People will think, maybe it is true, but actually, agriculture income must be taxed.
But okay. How? Excuse me.
Yes, who's this? Anybody asked?
Suruchi, I think Suruchi.
Suruchi, yes.
She has to unmute.
She's on mute, I think.
Suruchi, you are muted, please. Suruchi, you are still muted. You have to unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself.
Suruchi, unmute yourself.
She has.
My request is that if you start taxing the farmer, and we already have so many suicides and we have so much pain and misery in the villages, do you think that it would be a good policy?
I will give you two instances. One instance I will tell you, ma'am, last year in your Rotary International Fair, I got the award. And I was one of the 6 awardees in you have that annual Rotary Festival, which you have.
The DISCOM, district conference.
Yeah, the DISCOM, yes, yeah. The DISCOM. So last year I was one of the awardees. There were 6 of them and one was an agriculturist. That agricultural farmer, all of us are then allowed to ask to speak. The farmer was speaking last year, it's your program. I think February 2019. He came and said, he's an agriculturist and a farmer, cannot speak English. He was speaking in Hindi. Actually, he's a Maharashtrian. He said, I cannot understand how farmers commit suicide. I cannot understand. Because they are all stuck in the old methods of irrigation. Please learn new methods of irrigation and you will mint money. This is one. So I'm not going to say anything more. The second is agriculture. What is income tax, Suruchi? Income tax is paid when you earn more income. So if you have income more than 5 lakhs, shouldn't you pay tax? Nobody is saying you don't earn income and you have to pay tax. So the suicide wala case pass se hum income tax nahi lenge. तो इन इनकम एग्रीकल्चर इनकम टैक्स मिनिमम 10 लाख कर दो 20 लाख कर दो 1 करोड़ कर दो किसी ना किसी को तो पेमेंट करना चाहिए इनकम टैक्स हाउ कैन द लार्ज सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी व्हिच यू नो 70% ऑफ आवर सोसाइटी इज एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट्स नॉट पेइंग टैक्स सो व्हेन आई सेड आउट ऑफ 134 करोड़ ओनली 1.45 करोड़ पे टैक्स बिकॉज देयर आर 70-80 करोड़ देयर शोइंग आई एम एग्रीकल्चर सो आई डोंट हैव टू पे टैक्स व्हाट नॉनसेंस Are there no rich agriculturists? Zuruchi, please go to a village and see the number of BMWs and Mercedes-Benz which are roaming around. Don't pay income tax. What is this logic? Is this a fair country? Answer is no. But is this going to be, will somebody build a cap? Also, answer is no. It's not going to happen.
May I suggest something? Then why don't you start a lobby, a business called a lobby for modernizing irrigation and modernizing all the systems that should bring income and that should create the interest of people from the city in the villages.
Absolutely right. In my little way, I'm trying to do that. As I said, I'm the UDB chairman, ease of doing business chairman of Western India. I'm also finance and tax committee chairman of CIA Western India. In my little humble way, I'm trying to do that, Suruchi, to change this country. I have hopefully changed 43 of you today. Maybe many
Thank
of you. Maybe you,
you.
Have a little more hope now after why did I come for this 1 hour chat with you? Because I think that it is my duty that to bring hope and hope and optimism in all of us. India is a great country to do business. We are in a state where we are going to move up. But unless positivity in our mind, we must tell our children, kaam karo, but you know, most of us are looking for jobs. My humble submission, don't look for jobs. Look for opportunities where you are going to give jobs.
That's right. I agree with you. That Robin, is what we have to teach our youngsters.
Robin, your talk has been very encouraging and we are definitely hoping for the best. And the most positive was when you said that the pandemic is getting over in a lot of countries. And we are very sure that India also will follow. And we will be rid of all this crisis of pandemic, crisis of economy, and see better days very soon.